Welcome back to our channel, and thank you for tuning in and thank you for supporting us. But if you're new to this channel and you haven't subscribed yet, please encourage us by doing so, so that we can bring you the latest news as they come up. And together, we shall support our great leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, IPOB, and Eastern Security Network to make our Biafran dream a reality. IPOB expose the Fulani-controlled, compromised Nigerian security agencies of blocking roads and burning heavy-duty trucks in Southwest region of Nigeria. IPOB, in a statement, stated that the Nigerian Army operatives of the Department of State Services, the criminal DSS, and the Nigerian police were responsible for the so-called truck drivers' road blockage protests for the release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. It has become imperative for the general public, for the Nigerian public, for the gullible Nigerians, to know that it is the Nigerian security agencies that forced the drivers to block road with their trucks, and the same security agents with Ebubagu militia hoodlums set fire on those trucks carrying goods to Southeast. And it is not Eastern Security Network, nor unknown government or criminals. IPOB said that these Fulani Nigerian government terrorist security agents blocked all the major routes to Eastern region through Biafra land, especially the Igbo land, and refused all trucks carrying goods into Biafra. In the end, they set fire to those trucks loaded with consumable goods. It is not enough that the Fulani terrorist Nigerian government sabotaged the importation of goods through seaports into Biafra land. They have resorted to attacking trucks hauling goods into the eastern region of Biafra land, so as to create artificial scarcity that will cause the hike in prices of those goods. This is another agenda of the Fulani terrorist Nigerian government, using food and other goods blockade as a weapon of war, as they did against Biafrans during the 1967 to 70s genocide civil war. According to IPOB, the Nigerian security agents on Friday attacked trucks coming from Amoka in Iala local government area of Anambra State at the border community between Anambra and Imo States. IPOB is reliably informed that the Nigerian soldiers forced some of the truck drivers to block the roads, and to claim that it was Eastern Security Network operatives and IPOB members that forced them to do so. Imagine what the Fulani Nigerian government is doing. You know, the compromised Nigerian army that have been recruiting Fulani terrorists and Boko Haram terrorists into their formation and other security agencies forced truck drivers to block road in disguise of protesting that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu should be released without delay by the Fulani terrorist Nigerian government. Enugu-Aba Iguocha expressways were also blocked with six trucks. Enugu-Onitsha expressway near the toll gate was blocked with seven trucks. Obolo-Afo Enugu was also blocked by some truck drivers. IPOB never forced truck drivers to block the road in protest of Mazen Amde Kanu's release. IPOB knows how to handle issues without Nigerian security agents directing them on what to do. This arrangement to use truck drivers to block routes leading to the east is an agenda, a secret agenda of the Nigerian security agents to create unrest and to destroy our people's lives and properties. The Fulani terrorist Nigerian government have stationed Ebubago hoodlums to cause more harms to innocent people in many parts of Biafran land by setting fire to people's properties and vehicles. The Fulani terrorist Nigerian government, through her compromised security agencies, are waging a secret war against innocent Igbo Biafrans because Mazen Nnamdi Kanu comes from our region. We have numerous seaports in Biafra land where our businessmen and women can ship their goods to land, and it will be easy for them to collect. But the Fulani Nigerian government, out of wickedness, shut down all seaports in Biafra land. They shut it down. If the Fulani controlled Nigerian security agencies continue with this, their evil agenda of road and food blockade, sabotage, IPOB will confront them heads on. There is no amount of threat or intimidation that can make IPOB to retreat from Biafran restoration project. It is a done deal. We have crossed the Rubicon. Biafrans have crossed the Rubicon. The Fulani Janjaweed cannot stop us. We have crossed the Rubicon. They are busy arresting truck drivers and lying to them, telling them to lie, that when newsmen or people ask them, they should say it is IPOB or Eastern Security Network that asks them to protest against the Fulani Nigerian government. Imagine the tactics they are using. No wonder they went to appeal court and they were begging for time, for adjournment, so that they can commit so much havoc and come back and use those as evidence. You know, they thought they could shop for favorable judgment, but they failed. You know, the good thing about this is that Biafrans are not the ones fighting. It is Chukwuokika Biamma that is fighting for us. Because Biafra Restoration Project is Chukwuokika Biamma's divine mandate, which must come to pass. The earlier the Fulani Janjaweed gets this into their cow brain, the better for them. Biafrans will never back down. They will never retreat from the Biafra Restoration Project. We can never retreat. Thank you, my brothers and my sisters, for watching this video, and bye-bye for now.